Okay, first of all, we got to ask James Quiñones, the number one weather guy in Phoenix. How's the weather, brother?
It's really good, and it's good to be out here, Nick. Helping out at St. Vincent's de Paul, and Channel 12's involved a lot. It really means a lot. It really brings a true definition to what Christmas is all about, and it's about helping people. And if you can, you can do it. That's great. And if you can't, you know, it's tough. It's a really tough time, and I think this is, I'll never forget this for the rest of my life, this whole challenging time that we're going through this past 4 or 5 years. Our country's really struggling. So it's good to be able to come out here and to put a true definition as to what Christmas is all about.
And, you know, the reason that we're doing this interview right now is because people that have the microphone, so to speak, like Javier Soto and James Quiñones, they're not here just representing their TV stations. They're representing the community heart. Literally, we are building the veins that run the blood of love through the heart of this community. And Javier, what's it like for you when you get to do something and tell the stories of people that otherwise would not be told?
Well, it's about that. It's about the story. I mean, of course, we're all here for the story of Christ, Christmas, bringing everybody together. But it's about these untold stories, about these people who have struggled, who have had hard breaks and have come together, and they're just looking for a little help to help them get on their feet and move forward. And they're not alone, because there are a lot of people, especially in the last couple of years, who have fallen upon hard times and are just looking for a little bit of help. And I think that's what brought everybody here together, to just offer some support, offer a little inspiration, so that when they get back out there, they know that they're loved. They know that this is what it's all about. It's about Christmas and bringing everybody together, just to give that extra helping hand. So that's what today is all about.
You know, James, we joked about how you were washing dishes in Rhode Island, and here you are, you know, a star in one of the five biggest TV markets in the country. And to me, the other side of it is, whether you're an NFL player, just as quickly as we can have blessings in our life, we can have challenges and tragedies. All of us can have those things happen to us. What's that mean to you?
It's a long and it's a winding road life. And, yeah, we do have our ups and our downs. And, you know, I've seen a lot of good things, and I've seen a lot of bad turns. And I realize that when you see people that are down on their luck, it could be me, it could be my kid, it could be my friends. And we're all susceptible to that. Maybe we're just lucky. Maybe I just lucked out and got into the right career. And for whatever reason, I have a job right now and I'm able to provide for my family. And maybe somebody else on the street that's out there, they just ran into some bad luck. Maybe they're smarter than me. Maybe they're better. They just didn't get the right breaks. So I think you look at people and it makes you feel how fortunate you are, and that it is luck, and that you are blessed, and that God has blessed us, and he's smiling on me. So now you hope to take that and to say, you know, I'm going to do something with it. It might be something little, might be something as big as I can do, but I'm going to try to give back, because the person out there, that could be me, that could be my family.
Beautiful. You know, James, you sent me a picture from Midnight Mass last night, and in a way, this is its own church of love, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, it really is, and it is community, and you go to church to sort of focus, but this is also a place where you go and you focus, and you come together with your brothers and your sisters to just try to make sense of life. And I think, you know, we get so caught up in material and we get caught up in everything, that the real true meaning of it is coming together as family and to help people out that really need it. And that's what I want to remember when I'm an old man, you know, that hey, I had the ability to, and I stepped it up just a little bit. Maybe not a lot, but we all do what we can do. If you can't, that's understandable. If you're out working as hard as you can and you have to work on Christmas to feed your family, that's understandable. But if I had a little bit of time to hang out and to come out here and to do something, I think that's what I want to look at when I'm an old guy. I want to say, did I do the right things with it?
Rocking chair test. And Javier, Channel 12 has been here. Channel 3 always comes out. What's it feel like to be part of a television station that, you know, makes the extra effort to bring human faces to difficult situations and stories? Channel 3 does it all the time.
Well, we see it day to day, in and out. You know, tragedy is right there in front of us, and it's always how you respond to tragedy and trying to get the help from the community. I mean, over the last couple of weeks, we've seen a lot of house fires and people losing everything, and the community seems to step up. And so you're basically just reaching out to the community, telling those stories of those people who are struggling. And surprisingly, in difficult situations, the people of the community always open their hearts, open their arms, open their wallets. And we've seen that over the last couple weeks, especially with people losing stuff in fires. We had a Department of Public Safety officer lose his life in the line of duty, and the community seems to come together and just support the family, support the people who are in need, and then really deliver the true meaning of Christmas.
You know, the other message is that as hard as it is to grasp what it's like to be homeless for one day, you know, or to have a tragedy where that officer was run over and killed this week, and what that means for a lifetime for his wife and his family, you know, the other purpose of today for us and this conversation is to help people understand that a homeless person's homeless 365 days a year. They have to deal with challenges in terms of personal safety, in terms of health and nutrition, and of course finances, all those things, 365 days a year. We got somebody who's going to be a future advocate. She's got two associate degrees. What's it like for you when you see two people coming together from the two best stations, or two of the best stations in Phoenix? Because not because they're here, they're not being paid to be here. What's it mean when you see people doing like James and like Javier?
It feels good. It makes me feel like there really, truly are people out there who care.
Not just a job, right?
Exactly, exactly. We all have to have heart. And we have, and to use that heart to do something good with it, it just means everything.
Well, we just want to thank Javier Soto, who is a great reporter for Channel 3 and one of my best friends, James Quinones. They've got huge hearts, and you know, James was raising thousands of turkeys just a month ago, but you know what? It may be turkey one month. He's a turkey all the time, by the way. But it's always, you know, finding something to give, and it'll be the summertime, and it'll be hot. We'll try to figure out something to do in the summertime as well, but we appreciate all of you for being here, and we hope that in some small way, when you're watching this, you'll understand just a little bit better how easy it is to just make that little effort to contribute, whether it's to come back down here as a volunteer, to call other people, to be aware of it, to read about it, and realize the people here, yeah, they're people that have mental challenges, but and drug issues, et cetera. But under that, not this deep, but this deep, is a human being with a huge heart who just needs some support and love. So thanks for joining us today. Thanks, Javier. Thanks, James. And thanks,
Joanne
Sharman, and your incredible husband. Good luck. A year from now, he's going to have a job, and you're going to have your own home.
Yes.
And we're going to have you part of the St. Vincent de Paul's family as well. Thank you. Merry Christmas.